In the front lines of the horrors of slavery, the lives of Cecilia Flores Abanda and the children she helps are the extreme opposite from the high living on Hollywood. But for one night, they shared their story with Hollywood producers, executives, and celebrities.
Umiikot kami sa Amerika, umiikot kami sa ibang bahagi ng mundo para po i-educate yung mga tao. Para tigilan na po nila yung pag-patronize po ng mga products ng mga trafficking. Palawak din po ang network natin to track those traffickers who exploit our girls in our country.
Abanda, along with a trio of trafficking survivors, are touring the U.S. to raise awareness on the issues of human trafficking, working with their international partners such as Freedom for All, founded by former Ford Model Agency CEO Katie Ford.
Cecilia and the Sign Forum have become one of the groups that I work with the most, partially because Cecilia is incredible at taking opportunities that are given to her. She really knows how to use them and maximize it. And she is both caring and strategic.
Supermodel Rachel Hunter was among the crowd at Chateau Marmont, who was touched by the story of the three young girls who were forced to perform sex acts on a webcam.
Yeah, we might be child survivors, and we can also be part of the solution.
I was extremely affected by the girls' stories, you know, and the fact that this still goes on. And, you know, the whole cyber world, and we haven't figured out a way how to protect these girls is shocking. So I think the more the awareness, the more people talk and get this out there, the better.
Philippines remains one of the largest sources of human trafficking. In the case of these three girls, the perpetrators were based in the U.S. and have since been convicted for child pornography charges.
We cannot do it without the help of the government of the United States, yeah, because they are the one who is really persecuting and running after all these traffickers.
Some statistics estimate that as many as 29 million people live in slavery, which is estimated as a $32 billion underground industry.
We will not stop because we and the street discover new forms of trafficking.
20,000 lives saved sounds like an impressive number, but 20,000 is also a bittersweet reminder that even in this day and age, human trafficking remains an epidemic. But it's an epidemic that advocates like Cecilia hope to eventually end. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Hollywood.